But there is something about both SZA and Jhene Aiko where you know, like, they know something. You know what I mean? They know something about life. Hey, you guys, it's Crystal Sherelle from Indie Artist School. Welcome to the Singer's Arsenal. Today, we're going to talk about how to sing vocal runs like SZA and Jhene Aiko. These are two artists that are really on the scene, and they've been out here for a minute, but I gotta say, they are really breaking ground, and a lot of the singers that come to me who are learning how to sing R&B request to sing their songs. So, that being said, let's get into it. I don't know what it is about Jhene Aiko and SZA, but their music simply hits different. That was cheesy, okay? I know. But I had to say it, okay? Because I love the nostalgic 90s feel to, especially SZA, to their runs. So I ended up choosing Hit Different, which I kind of teased in the beginning, so it's no surprise, as the song that we're gonna discuss today. SZA is, listen, she is so chill. She makes everything sound very effortless. Remember last week I said Frank Ocean's like the boy next door? Well, SZA's the girl next door, literally, okay? She's got that vibe visually and also musically. That being said, it doesn't mean her runs are simple, okay? They are actually pretty quick, and usually on the pentatonic scale, she does like to do three note runs. If you listened to last week's episode, then you know what I was telling you about Brent Faiyaz and Frank Ocean doing the similar thing there. Vocal runs are usually saved for, you know, certain verses or that one word at that one part. You know what I mean? But when it's in a hook, it's really cool because you got a lot of opportunities to sing that run. And so, yeah, that's what we're gonna do today. All right, so let's get into it. We are not gonna play the whole song, okay? Ain't nobody got time for that, first of all. And also, I'm not trying to get this video taken down, okay? All the credit goes to SZA and Ty Dolla $ign. Because this is a collab, some of the runs that Ty is doing is also very amazing too. I didn't even put him in the topic, but I probably should have. Without further ado. All right, so here we go, let's get into it. Like, I'm very tempted to like break down that entire intro because, oh my God, the harmonies. But this is a vocal run episode and there's a lot of runs in here. They're stacked on top of each other. But let's focus on SZA first. Okay, hold on, Crystal. Don't do it. Don't do it. Let's keep moving. We're keeping it moving, okay. So that first part. Decline. So that one is a very short run. Decline. Three notes down. Decline. Which we talked about earlier. Decline. And then it goes back up. Declining. And then it goes back down. So she just did a little three note run, which, I mean, hey, we love to have those. They're really fun just to jazz things up. So that opening line in the hook is the first run in the hook, which is fun. It's a very simple run. All that I know is no. So it's very similar to what we talked about last week, but hey, we love to build new habits, okay? That middle note is short. No, no. Slow it down first. No. All that I know is. All right, go all the way down on the is. And if you find yourself getting a little muffled on the low notes, especially ladies, I know sometimes these low notes are hard for some of us. If you're finding that to be true for you, a little trick you can do is say as like a ah sound rather than eh, just because it changes the shape of your mouth and where your tongue is so that it's a lot more forward in your mouth rather than in the back of the throat. Because on low notes, we don't want to be in the back of the throat, guys. When you're back there, it is hard to hear the low note, okay? So try it with me. All that I know is. Yes. All right, and that's giving me like TLC. I don't know why I'm saying that, but it's giving me 90s, right? It's giving me It's giving me that ah sound. It's giving me that whiny sound, and it's really bringing it forward, okay? So if you want to have that kind of, I don't know, throwback nostalgic vibe and also a resonant low note, go ahead and make it more like an ah sound than it is sound, okay? All right, let's keep it moving and see what's coming up next. Okay, so let's break down that me. So obviously the beginning is that plea. So if you're trying to get up there and jump from a low note, please don't. So there's a big jump between those two. The goal is to not make them sound like totally different parts of your voice. You wanna make them sound as similar as possible. So when you go up to that high note, you don't wanna make your mouth so different in shape from the lower note. That way you have more cohesion between different parts of your voice. Please duh. So I kind of keep my inner smile so I can get up there with ease. Please. And you want to also allow a little air to come out through the nose when you go up there. Please don't deny me. So we're going to talk about that run going down. Me. E. There's four notes going down. E. Try that. E. All right. A. Let's get it. E. Ooh, all right. E, all right. So did you get those four? If you got those four at that speed, now we're gonna speed it up a little bit. E, all right, try that. E, all right, one more time. E, all right. Please don't deny me. That's how you do it. So go ahead and try it a few times, jumping from that high note. Please don't. Make sure you get those notes correct before you move on, and then you got the rest. E. All right. Does that make sense? Hopefully it does. Leave it in the comments if you got it. Leave it in the comments if you're like struggling. Okay. Just type in struggling and I'll know. All right. And if you're listening to the podcast, just make sure that you are rewinding if you need to try this in your car or wherever you are. So ad-libs are fun too because there's a run in there. All right, I don't know if y'all heard it. Here it is. Hit different. It's very simple, but it's quick. Hit different. Those are the three notes. Hit different. So if you want to know how to sing it, hit different. That's how it goes. And then you just speed it up. Hit different. And that's all you got to do. That's it. All right. So now I'm not saying that's all SZA's got because she's got a lot. I want to get to this one part. Let me see if I can find it. Okay. I love that one. Let's listen to how she said chill. Out of my way, you had a pack in me, clear vision, boy. Clear vision, boy. That part is cool too. I am chill. So it's chill. So three going down, two going up. Chill. Let's do that. Chill. So it's three down. We got that first one going up. Now we're going to do that last one going up. Chill. All right, you got it? Chill. And then we're gonna speed it up. Chill. Try that. I am chill. I am chill. Try that. I am chill. All right, that's how you do it. You gotta start slow and then you speed it up. All right, I love that part of the song. I was like, come on, SZA. Like, you didn't have to do us like this, okay? Sometimes runs are not about doing the most. Uh-oh, Good Days was about to start. Don't get me started on that. Anyway, it's not always about doing the most all the time. Like, sometimes it's just, you could run short distances. I would like to call these runs sprints. You know what I'm saying? Like, let's get there real quick, but we are certainly accurate about the notes that we're singing. That's one of the things I gotta commend artists like SZA and Jhene Aiko on. So speaking of Jhene Aiko, let's get into her runs. What is she doing? Oh, okay. So like, obviously this is about runs, but I can't ignore her tone and her vibe. Okay. So we're going to talk about her onset and how she's able to get that super laid back sound when she's singing, as well as the runs that she's doing. So let's check her out. Before we get into this, I just want to say that when I pulled up Jhene Aiko Magic Hour, wow. The top comment said, if essential oils could talk, it would be Jhene. And look, they're not wrong. And I know last time I was talking about vibes and artists being similar and stuff like that, and where they're also different, but there is something about both SZA and Jhene Aiko where, you know, like, they know something, you know what I mean? They know something about life, and they are very in touch with their emotions and how they're feeling, and they are not afraid to express them. And I just wanted to kind of, you know, pay homage to these artists who are expressing this side of themselves. And we need this at this time, okay? Like, yes, please, please. So we're gonna go ahead and unpack all of the fun runs. Although this song is not like a demonstrative song, it's really about the vibe, but there are some runs in Magic Hour, so we're gonna unpack them. Let's listen. Chill until the sun sets, waiting for the magic hour. Now, one of the things that I said that we would also touch on when we listen to Jhene Aiko is her onset. So she has a lot of a sound with her voice. It's a soft onset. So if you ever want to know how you can get more of a vibey sound to your voice, just put an H in front of your vowels. So our, most people say our like that, okay, which makes sense. Our literally has a silent H in front of it, but for Jhene, all of her vowels have a present H, so to speak. Our, like that. Our. Just a real smooth vibe. If you saw my episode way back about Sade, she did that too. She does that too. I don't know where she's been. I think she's just like hiding and living her best life. But anyway, we're not gonna get into that. But tone, soft onset, yes and yes, okay? Now, this is actually very helpful when you are singing runs, because usually if you hold on to the note too hard, it makes the note harder to move. So your agility suffers a little bit. So it's no surprise that Jhene can move quickly between notes, and why she also loves to do trills. We'll talk about more on that later, but let's listen to what she's got. Opening line. In wah, wah, wah. That's another three note. In wah. So that's the first opening run that she had, and she kind of letting you know, like, hey, we're here, even though we're vibing out. She's like, this is still R&B, okay? All right, okay. All right, so if you're wanting to know how to do that run, let's get up there first. And it's the same thing I told you on the hit different run on the hook. The same concept. You want to raise the tongue and then allow more air to come through the nose so you can get an easier time when you sing that high note, and you don't want to change the shape of your mouth too drastically. It's a similar concept there. It was, right? Just keep it there. It was. Keep an inner smile as you sing. It was. And put an H on it. It was. Just to give it a little bit more of a smooth tone when you sing it. And then watch how you just glide through those notes like butter. And if you're not gliding like butter and it's a little bit more like peanut butter in the fridge on your bread, it's okay. Take your time with it, slow it down first. It was. Do that first. It was. Then you can speed it back up. It was. And then you're good to go, all right? So let's see what else she's got. Okay, I know there's more. We're gonna talk about it. That night. Now, so it's another three note night, but she has so much precision and accuracy and speed that it just really adds character to the phrase night. So honestly, you guys, practice this a few times slow, speed it up, and once you've got it, yes, have fun with it. And again, remember that soft onset to help you glide through those notes like Jhene's teaching us. Nah, she uses her nose. Nah, like that, and it just makes it come easier. So now let's talk about by. She added an extra note. It's very similar to what she did on night, except there's one extra note at the bottom. Drew me by, four notes, by, yeah. So have fun with it, by, and then speed it up. By, drew me by. And then one other thing to think about with Jhene that makes her very unique and just gives her that signature sound is that she is very playful with the rhythm on the runs themselves. And whereas Sza also is a very fun rhythmic R&B singer as well, and she plays around with cadences in her verses, Jhene does it a lot with her runs with the timing on them. So bye, bye. So all those three notes after the first one are very quick. And that's what I was trying to tell you about that agility on this girl, okay? She's not playing games out here. So if you thought she was a simple singer, let me tell you. You know what I've found out is usually the singers that make it sound the easiest, they get overlooked. People don't call them powerhouses. I think it's just because they make it sound so easy that you think it is easy, because sometimes they're using simple things, but they're doing it in a very well-executed way that I think people underestimate the skill level it takes to be able to do that accurately, okay, and on point. So don't let anything sway you. If you are digging Jhene like I do, if you're digging Sza like I do, yes, like, sing you some Sza, sing you some Jhene. It will definitely let you get your voice together, okay? I really enjoyed covering how to sing runs like Sza and Jhene Aiko. There's a lot of things that I love about both of these vocalist voices. And I just wanna say this to you right now as you're listening. If you're thinking, I don't sound like Jhene, or I don't sound like Sza, or I don't sound like Brent Faiyaz, or anybody I've ever covered, don't take that to mean that you're not an amazing singer. The goal is to find your own voice. It doesn't hurt to try learning some techniques from other artists so that you can understand how your voice sounds when you sing those notes, right? There's a lot of techniques you can learn from listening to different R&B singers to help you enhance your own R&B voice. If you would like to develop your R&B voice, go ahead and check out my website, indieartistschool.com. I have an online course called the R&B Singer's Arsenal, where I teach you how to sing as well as develop your voice so that you can overcome the obstacles with your vocal range, maybe your cracking, straining, all of that mess that you're trying to get over. Go ahead and click the link below to go ahead and sign up for the course. Also, if you want one-on-one coaching sessions, I have the link below to book a consultation for that as well. And if you're listening to the podcast and you want to support so that I can keep these episodes going, first of all, I just want to say thank you to those who are already donating. You're absolutely amazing, okay? Just want you to know, keep it up. If you want to support, go to anchor.fm/thesingersarsenal/support. That's anchor.fm/thesingersarsenal/support. Well, you guys, until next time, have a wonderful day.